Welcome to ECE at OU's Electronics Tutorial Series. Today we're going to be covering node voltage. Now, node voltage is a nice little tool that you can use to help you analyze circuits to determine the voltage and current at different points and branches throughout the circuit. Now, the three things that you'll need to know before we get started here are Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, Ohm's law, and how to solve systems of equations. We're going to assume that you already know how to do these. If you don't, we will add some tutorials later on some of these. You can also find some good information about these online or in your electronics textbook. Now, the first thing you need to know, we'll just review real quick, is a very quick review of Kirchhoff's current law. This basically states that for every node, the amount of current going in has to equal the amount of current going out. So in this case here, we're using the red arrow to show a current flowing into a node, and the green arrows to show the current flowing out of the node. Now, if the red arrow indicates a current of, say, 3 amps, this could mean that this green arrow could have 2 amps going out, this green arrow could have 1 amp going out, could be the other way around, any combination of the two, as long as the current of the two green arrows is equal to the amount of current that is coming into this node. The next point that you'll need to remember is essential nodes. Now, essential nodes are nodes that have 3 or more branches coming into them. Now, what we mean by branches is, say, this node right here, there's 1 branch, 2 branch, and 3 branches. But this node here, we only have 2 branches. So this branch itself is not an essential node, while this one is. Okay. For our first example, I've drawn us a simple circuit here, and you can see that it includes a 10-volt battery or power supply and 4 resistors, R1, R2, R3, R4. All of these have a value of 10 ohms. So the first thing we need to do is to identify our essential nodes. Now remember, an essential node is a node with 3 or more branches going into it. So we'll see that call this first one up here, V1. And the other essential node in this circuit we'll call V2. Now, next, what we'll need to do is determine how many equations we're going to need to solve this. Now, that's pretty easy to do, and we can say that the number of essential nodes minus 1 is equal to the number of equations that we need. So in this case, we have 2 essential nodes, so 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. That's good. It means we only have 1 equation to solve for. Now, to write these equations, we're going to use a form of Ohm's law. And you'll remember that V equals IR. So we can say that I is equal to voltage over resistance. One more thing that we're going to do to make this a little easier on ourselves is to add a ground reference. Now, we can do this because the circuit has no predefined ground, and normally what you want to call your ground reference node would be your most complicated node, or just a node that makes things easier for you. In this case, the easiest one is going to be this node right here. So I drew it over here, but keep in mind that all of this down here is all node 2, or V2 as we're going to call it. Now, what that does for us is it allows us to call V2 equal to 0, and that tells us immediately that the voltage here is 10 volts. I'll go ahead and write that one in, 10 volts. Now, what we're going to do is use Kirchhoff's current law to sum up the currents going in and out of the different nodes. We're going to make things standard and say that all of the currents are going away from the node. So node V1, the one we're going to solve for, since we already know that V2 is equal to 0 volts thanks to our ground reference. And so we're going to solve for this current, this current, this current. And remember, Kirchhoff's current law says that all of the currents going in and out of a node must sum up to 0. So let's look at this first one, going from right to left from V1. So using Ohm's law, we're going to say V1 minus 10 volts, which is the potential voltage, or the voltage across here, the potential. So V1 minus 10 over R1, which is going to be 10 ohms, plus, next we'll do from top to bottom, V1 to V2, which is V1 minus 0, because remember V2 is 0, over R2, which is 10 ohms. And next one is this one going from left to right, so that's V1, this is not an essential node, so we're going to skip it, down to V2, which is 0, so V1 minus 0, all over R3 plus R4, so that's 10 plus 10, that's 20, and that equals to 0. Now, this might look a little daunting at first, but you can really quickly look and see that it's three currents being summed up, since we're representing current as voltage over resistance. So we have a voltage difference over a resistance to represent this branch, voltage over resistance, and voltage over resistance. And Kirchhoff's current law says that the sum of all of those equals zero, so that makes our right-hand side really simple. So let's simplify these equations a little further and go ahead and solve for V1. I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 20. So what that'll allow us to do is say 20 divided by 10 is 2, so that's going to be 2 V1 minus 20 plus 20 again divided by 10, that's another 2 V1. 2 times 0 is 0, so we'll just leave it alone. And then 20 divided by 20 is 1, so that just leaves us with a plus V1, and 0 times 20 is 0. Let's go ahead and collect our terms up here. So we have 2V1, another 2V1, and then 1V1. So that leaves us with 5V1, and we can go ahead and move the negative 20 to the other side by adding 20 to each side of the equation, and we can say that 5V1 equals positive 20. Now to solve for V1, we can obviously divide by 5 on each side, so that leaves us with V1 being 4 volts. So what that tells us is that V1 is equal to 4 volts. I'll write that up here. And with that knowledge, we now know the voltage difference across every single node here. So we know that there's 6 volts difference here, and 10 ohms of resistance, so we can calculate the current flow through there, 4 volts across here, 10 ohms, and then that there's 4 volts split across here, which across the 20 ohms, so that we can calculate that current. And if we needed to know what the voltage is here, you could really easily use the voltage divider rule. So that's our first example. I want to take a moment to really put some emphasis on drawing your arrows pointing away from the node that you're going to be writing an equation for. We do this because it's quite frankly going to make our lives easier when it comes time to start doing manipulation of the equations. So why do we do this? It's all due to Kirchhoff's current law. So Kirchhoff's current law again says that the sum of the currents going out of a node must be equal to the amount of current going into a node. So let's assume that current A is actually flowing into the node. So we have current A, and that has to mean that means that the currents going out from B and C have to be equal to current A. Now, if we assume that current A is 5 amps, and we could say then that current B might be 2 amps, and current C might be 3 amps. If we rearrange the equation a little bit, we can say that 2 plus 3 minus 5 equals 0. Or, in the same way, we could say 2 plus 3 plus minus 5 is equal to 0. Now, when we go to actually write our nodal equations, they won't be nice numbers like this. It'll be variables over constants and so on. And manipulating an equation where all of the signs are the same and all of the terms are on one side of the equation and the other side is a zero is much, much easier than it would be trying to manipulate an equation in the form like this. So again, make sure that all of your arrows are always pointing out. Use them as your reference when you're writing out your nodal equations. Okay. Now for example two. As you can see, it's a little bit more complicated in that we have three essential nodes now instead of two, and I've also added a current source. Again, all of the resistors are 10 ohms, the voltage source is 10 ohms, the current source will be 1 amp going in this direction, and I've already assigned our ground reference point and drawn three arrows to represent the branches that we're going to be analyzing here. Now, I'm sorry I've had to draw this a little small, I need a little more room here to write. If you need to, go ahead and pause the video, copy down this figure on your own notes if you're taking notes, and we'll go ahead and get started. Now, for the because we have three essential nodes, we'll need to do two simultaneous equations. So we'll start with V1. So for V1, we'll go from right to left. That'll be V1 minus the 10 volts on the other side of this resistor, R1. And the value of R1 is 10, plus V1 minus 0, because remember we're calling our ground reference 0, so V1 minus 0 over R2, which is 10 volts, or 10 ohms, I'm sorry. And then our last one will be from V1 minus V2, and that's going to be over R3, which again is 10 ohms. And all of that will be equal to 0, just as before. Now, I'm going to go ahead and multiply both sides of the equation by 10, and that will get rid of the tens here on the bottom and make things much simpler for us. Of course, when you're working circuits by yourself or when you're doing homework assignments, they're probably not going to wind up being this easy. I've chosen these numbers so they come out easy so we can get through these examples fairly quickly. So if we multiply everything by 10, that's 10 divided by 10, equals 1, so we're left with V1 minus 10 plus 10 over 10 is 1 again, so that's just V1. The 0 is nothing for us, plus 10 over 10, which is 1, so that leaves us with V1 minus V2 equals 0. Now I'm going to go ahead and collect the terms up. We have 3 V1s, so that's 3 V1 minus a V2. And I'll move the 10 to the other side. So that's 3V1 minus V2 equals 10. We'll go ahead and highlight that one so it stands out for us. And then we'll go ahead and move on to V2. Now for V2, we'll again start from here and go to V1. So that's V2 minus V1 to get us our voltage difference across this resistor, which is R3, and that is 10 ohms. Then we have V2 minus 0 across R4, which is 10 ohms again, so V2 minus 0 over 10. And then I'm going to leave that as a minus sign here, and I'll show you why. This current source makes this branch look like something we haven't seen before. But because it's a current source, that means we already know the current flowing through this branch, and there's no need for us to figure out what the voltage difference is and the resistance. So because this is 1 amp and it's going into our green arrow, we're going to leave it as a minus 1. If this current source was pointing the other direction, it would be in the same direction as the green arrow, and we would actually say plus 1, but it's going into it, so it's a minus. And that, of course, is all equal to 0. So again, we'll simplify by multiplying both sides by 10, and that's going to leave us with V2 minus V1 plus V2 minus 10 times 1 is 10 equals 0. I'll collect the terms up. That leaves us with 2V2 minus V1, and I'll move the 10 to the other side, so that's plus 10 there. And let's highlight that one as well so we don't forget it. So now we're left with our two equations and our two unknowns. So this should be pretty simple to solve for. What we're going to do is pick either one of these equations, it doesn't really matter which one, and we're going to rearrange it so that we just have one of our unknowns on one side. I think this one should be pretty easy. This one's probably just as easy, but I'll go ahead and do this one on this side. So if we move the V1 to this side and the 10 to the other, we're left with 2V2 minus 10 equals V1. So that's just a little bit of algebraic manipulation, and now we know that V1 is equal to 2V2 minus 10. So what can we do with that? Well, what we're going to do is take this value here, and we're going to plug it into this equation over here. So let's see what that does. We have 3 times V1. Well, we know that V1 is 2V2 minus 10. So we'll write 2V2 minus 10, and then minus V2, and that equals 10. So let's go ahead and multiply this out. That's 6V2 minus 30 minus V2 equals 10. And if we collect our terms, we have 5V2, we'll move the 30 to the other side, so that equals plus 40. And now all we have to do is divide both sides by 5, so we have V2 is equal to 8 volts. That was pretty simple there, wasn't it? Let's highlight that. And we'll go ahead and write that up here. V2 is equal to 8 volts. So now we can take that value that we just got and plug it into our original equation. So we know that V2 is 8 volts. So we can say that 2 times 8 from up here, V2, minus V1 equals 10. It probably actually would have been easier. Yeah, let's do that. Sorry about that. We'll just use this one instead of that one, since we've already solved for V1. So that's 2 times 8 minus 10 is equal to V1. So that's 16 minus 10 equals V1. So we know that V1 is equal to 6 volts. So there you have it. We had 3 essential nodes, which meant that we needed to solve for 2 equations, 6 volts here. And with those 2 equations, we rearranged one of them, plugged that value into the first equation, solved for our V2, and then used that value of V2 to solve for our value of V1. Now we know the voltage at each of those essential nodes. You can use that to calculate your currents, anything else that you might need for that circuit. And that is the basics of node voltage. For our next tutorial, you'll find a video on node voltage with dependent sources. So what that is that instead of having a fixed current or a fixed voltage source, they're going to change depending on what voltages are in other parts of the circuit. So I look forward to teaching you guys that, and we'll see you later.